In this video, I'm going to show you my next generation of 3D printer enclosure ventilation and everything I learned along the way. Over a year ago, I built a ventilation system for my Voron printer using a PC fan. This has worked brilliantly. It moves plenty of air and is nice and quiet. But recently I moved my workshop to the basement and bought another printer, so I had to upgrade the ventilation. The ducting runs for 4 meters through two walls, so it's not as simple as when I was sat next to an opening window. On the Bambulab P1S, the ducting connects with the enclosure exhaust port on the back. A magnetic connector with two screws allows it to securely connect to the back and lock in place. The ducting connects to a junction, so you can turn the ventilation on or off for either printer. And then the ducting heads off through a double brick wall. It wasn't easy to cut this hole, so I wouldn't necessarily recommend doing that. Anyway, it makes several turns before getting to the inline fan, which draws the air through the system. It then pipes through a vent to outside the house. I 3D printed the 90 degree connectors in two parts, so they're easy to print without supports, then glue and bolted them together. Also, the connectors have little holes in the side, so they're easy to hang on the walls and the ceiling. The inline fan moves a lot of air. This was the smallest fan I could get, and even on its lowest setting, it moves heaps of air. Maybe too much air, I'd say. But unfortunately, the inline fan died after 6 months, so I decided to build my own fan out of PC fans. A key learning I've found is that you don't need a hurricane to ventilate. You just need a nice, gentle breeze. You only need just enough pull to keep the air moving. In fact, I found that just having the ducting connected up was enough to make a noticeable difference with the Bambulab P1S fumes, because it's got its own small enclosure fan. Before I built an inline fan out of PC fans, I had to prove that they would create enough suction to work over the 4 meters of ducting. I found this document on the Noctua website. They confirmed that the fans in series will increase the static pressure, so I set off to do some testing myself. For the testing, I got 4 PC fans, 12 volt power supply to run them all, and I'm going to gradually add fans and also add these stators or flow guides in between the fans to see if they improve the flow. And ultimately I've got top guides, which on the previous exhaust fan fans very useful, really helps with the airflow. So gonna do a whole bunch of tests and see how we go with these. So this is a pressure test, a little meter I made, and it's got no weight on it, so it floats up there. But if I had a metal washer, then this is 6 grams on that. And that weighs it down so we can see it. Just, it's about a millimeter above the bed, above the top of the fan, so we can see roughly how hard it's pushing. Now I'll go ahead and add another fan. Not using these guys yet, just add fans, see what effect just adding fans makes. And just plug that guy in. It does lift it more, so having 2 sequential fans does actually increase the static pressure. So I'll go and add fan number 3. Alright, we measure number 3, see how much push it's got. So I suppose it'll only raise up so much before it lets the air out, and that'll be sufficient. So we could actually put another washer on. And it's down to about 1, but you can hear the air pushing a lot more. So 3 fans is definitely better than 2. Gonna add 4, 4th fan there. And it doesn't really look like that much difference. It's interesting, the pressure thing here is actually rotating a lot, so the air must be spinning a lot. Alright, so what I think we'll do now is test with adding these guys and see if it makes a difference. So I'll try and slot them in one at a time. So I'll start here at the top. Let's see if that makes a difference. Oh, and it does. That's quite a significant lift. It is much more effective. Let's put another one in. So this is with two statins. Let's test that and see how high it lifts. Yeah, so that's lifting higher again. So will putting a third one in help? Yeah, I think it's actually gone higher again. So adding these individual statins is actually having quite a beneficial effect on static pressure. It's not just having just fans is not enough, but adding these statins which help guide the airflow as it progresses up. And this is basically how a jet engine works. You have a blade, then a stator, so the air, instead of just getting spun more and more, it actually gets directional push upwards. Afterwards, I noticed the Noctua site said you should have a 45-60 mil spacer between two fans. So I've got a spacer here with no blades, so I'll try this out and see how it compares to having the bladed spacers in between. And that just lifts it off. So the bladed statins are definitely more effective than just leaving a gap. I decided two fans would be enough with the statins. The enclosure is printed in three pieces. There's the middle bit and the end guides, the end stator, and the inlet. So these fans fit inside and the cables route up here. Took out the old fan and put the new fan in, and it's ready to turn on. Did a quick smoke test too to check the airflow, and it looks good, and it's nice and quiet too. And the last thing to do is to pull out the carbon filter, as that just slows down the airflow. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe.